Federal government don't declare Monday, November 11, as public holiday. Senate don't demand the building of fire stations for big markets across Nigeria. DSS men, where them attached to Vice President Yemi Osinbajo, don't allegedly panabit photojournalists where they work with Vanguard newspaper. And court don't shift the case where involve Abdulrasheed Maina, will be before Chiamo Pension Reform Tax Team till November 21. My country people, I twirl for this evening. My name na Nna Douglas. Now the Tory as the Tory, the Tory as it pour like water inside basket. Federal government don't declare Monday, November 11 as national holiday to mark the 2019 Eid al-Maulud celebration. The event na to mark the birthday of Prophet Muhammad. When they announced this one for one statement, Minister of Interior Rauf Aregbesola will congratulate Muslim people on top of the occasion, tell them say, make them live within the virtues and teachings of Prophet Muhammad. Will be love, courage, and perseverance. Just as he had say, if they do all these ones, it will guarantee peace and security inside Nigeria. When they express confidence, say the current wahala where Nigeria they face will soon be over, the Minister of Interior can't even beg Nigerian people, say make them remain focused and believe, say, everything will soon better. Meanwhile, the federal government talks, say, the task of turning economy and security around could be easier if they fit tackle corruption. Minister of Information and Culture, Lai Mohammed, now talked this one on Thursday for one special town hall meeting where they organized inside Abuja to show how they go use pursue corruption come out from the country. Oga Lai Mohammed talk say, Obonge government don't bring kaja things to take send corruption packing. Things like bank verification number, BVN, treasury single account, TSA, and others. He come to beg Nigerians say, make them embrace the war against corruption and give every necessary support to federal government so that war against corruption will succeed. And for the next story, for the meantime, Senate don't ask the federal government say, make them build functional fire stations for all big markets across the country to check the one way be say fire no they let people mind rest again. Senate, after debate on top one motion where concern traffic fuel tanker fire disaster for Onitsha, come tell federal government say make them give money support to people where be say the fire accident affect their business so that they can start their business life again. When it chook mouth on top the debate, Senator Ike Ekweremadu come advise say, it will make sense make market people register their business for insurance.
We have an act establishing the insurance industry in Nigeria, and I'm aware that it made it compulsory for public institutions and places such as markets to insure such buildings and the compound. But we are not used to insurance in this country. So it is time for us to find a way of letting people know the benefit of insurance, to let them understand that insurance is key, because when these things happen, we may have to fall back on insurance.
As the young with journalist after plenary, person who sponsored the motion, Senator Ifeanyi Oba, explained, say, it would be risky to give particular time for heavy-duty vehicles to run for road.
I agree on the time that vehicles making vehicle pass in the night. If, for example, petroleum, you know the need of petroleum to Nigerians, and most of the petroleum that we consume, 90% of them comes through tanker drivers. In a state like Anambra State, that is in between Ebonyi, Abia, Enugu, Imo State, and you have the whole long stretch of vehicles waiting to pass overnight. I mean, it means in the whole night, all the whole state will be, that will be more dangerous to people sleeping, because if we have one single incident of fire disaster or explosion or tanker accident in the night, the whole state or even neighboring states can be in there. So we need to, this is why we are in Senate to debate issues. So you can look at it from your own perspective and find it better, oh, they should move in the night. But what of a position where you find in the night you have 200 tankers just in the whole street? Anything can happen. An angry man can ignite one and the whole place will be littered. And then that will be, so you look at it, it comes, from their own position and from the position of other people. Our position is that every tanker must meet safety requirements. And then once this bill is passed, Nigerians will be happy.
And after every lawmakers can observe 1 minute silence to honor people who kaput for the fuel tanker accident which happened for October 16, 2019. Still on top National Assembly matter, Senate Presido Ahmed Lawan don't want to say Nigerians and even foreigners go hardly invest to support Nigerian economy if government no tackle security problem. He make the comment after one point of order on top matters of national importance will be say na Senator Olalekan Mustafa raise on Wednesday for plenary.
Urgent need for security agencies to intervene in the increased rate of kidnapping in the riverine areas of Ogun East Senatorial District and securing the waterways. The Senate notes with urgent and grave concern the recent increase in the activities of criminal syndicates who specialize in kidnapping and militancy in and around the riverine communities in Ogun East Senatorial District, particularly Odeomi, Makun, and Iwokun in Ogun Waterside local government area of Ogun State. Concerned that the activities of these criminals have forced law-abiding residents of coastal communities of the affected areas to flee their communities and livelihood out of fear.
The Senate President can also call for more money inside budget allocation to security agencies, who will give them the muscle to fight banditry, kidnapping, insurgency, and other criminal activities across the country. He say it will make sense to establish national emergency centers across Nigeria which will make them easier to fight criminal activities for Nigeria.
A better and more operable and result-oriented approach to fighting kidnapping and the insecurity we face. And we have insisted here that no amount of resources will be too much because we need to secure our people, we need to secure this country. It will remain a pipe dream if we continue to ask for people to come to Nigeria to invest. Actually, even those inside Nigeria may not invest properly once the security situation remains very dicey. So this is something that we have to do together with the executive arm of government.
For another one we resemble them, the Senate President can suggest, say, make the Office of the National Security Advisor send different models of drones we will help check where badness they happen. And for this news, we no sweet belly at all. Security men were then attached to Vice President Yemi Osinbajo don't panabit one photojournalist where they work with Vanguard newspapers, Abayomi Adeshida, where them attached to cover Aso Rock. The assault happened today, Thursday, inside State House Banquet Hall, Abuja, for the opening session of the Nigerian Diaspora Investment Summit, where we say now the Nigerians in Diaspora Commission, NITCOM, organize them, and na Abike Dabiri Erewa chair them. When it narrate what happened, the photojournalist talks say it is snap pictures of where the vice president they walk around for exhibition stand for the program when five security people from the Department of State Services, DSS, sharply pounce on them. They beat them black and blue. Adeshida talks say none of the security officials approach him to tell him whether he did obstruct the event or cross where he no supposed cross. But they can't start to hit him, they drag him for ground, even as they damage in professional camera right in front of the vice president. This badness happened one day after a report talks say then sack 35 people where they work with the vice president on the orders of President Muhammadu Buhari, where they for United Kingdom now for one private visit. And make we enter another story. Federal High Court, where they sit inside Abuja, don't shift the trial of the before Chiamo of Pension Reform Tax Team, Abdulrashid Meina, to November 21 and 22, 2019. Justice Okuna Bangtok say, this one are to allow the Nigerian Correctional Service really check the true state of Meina health, where then carry come court today for wheelchair. Then take arguments from both prosecution and defense counsel on whether or not to proceed with the case, considering the body matter of the defendant, will be Meina. But sake of one medical report where Meina being present for court, the prosecutor can't tell the court, say, since it don't be like this now, make them shift the case to the 21st and 22nd of November to allow Nigerian Correctional Service, NCS, check him health status and fitness to stand trial. Justice Abang, sake of this one, can adjourn the case to 21st and 22nd of November. Nobi Tori again to remind you, say the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, ESCC, they tried the former chairman of Pension Reform Tax Team, sake of one accusation of 2 billion naira pension money we don't borrow leg now. And for crime matter, men of the Nigerian Security and Civil Defense Corps, NSCDC, inside Kaduna State on Thursday, don't rescue 8 people where Abubi boys kidnapped on top one operation where they do inside the state capital. The state NSCDC commandant, Babangida Dutsima, when he briefed journalists on top of the matter, talks say the victims will include 2 babies and 5 women. They kidnapped them on Monday morning, just as he talks say they don't arrest 2 of the suspected kidnappers. Dutsima talks say the kidnappers act like say they be commercial taxi drivers, come kidnap their victims for Kawo area along Kaduna Zaria Road. He explains say NSCD officials where they act on intelligence and like James Bond sharply pursue the kidnappers, come catch them and rescue the victims. The commandant reveals say they also grab 1 5-man internet fraudsters where get Sabines to the dupe members of the public, and even he talks say they don't arrest foreigners, among them now 2 ladies and 3 men. My people, the program now as it take happen with a show back with business news. And for inside business news, federal government through the Nigerian Customs Service don't direct say make them no supply petroleum products to fuel stations where they 20 kilometers away from the borders. Customs Controller General will be Hamid Ali now issued the directive for one memo where then date November 6 and at the Deputy Controller General on top enforcement, investigation and inspection, Chidi A, now sign them. The memo talks say then go carry out the order under the ongoing Operation Swift Response where they supervise the land border closure. Una fit remember say the before Group Managing Director GMD of the Nigerian National Petroleum Corporation, NNPC, Mekanti Baru, been raised one alarm on top the high number of filling stations for border towns. He said people they use the fuel stations, they smuggle oil to neighboring countries. The NNPC GMD been talk say now 16 states with total of 61 local government areas connect to border communities and then get 2,201 fuel stations where then register. My people, the sports, the Tori, or as it take happen, remain sports news with a comeback. And on top sports news this night, Super Eagles coach Gennaro Rohr talks say he they expect to start preparations for Nigeria's 2021 African Cup of Nations qualifier against Benin Republic this Saturday inside Nigeria. Super Eagles go meet the Squirrels of Benin for the first game of the AFCON qualifiers inside Uyo on Wednesday. That is Wednesday next week. Super Eagles media officer Toyin Ibitoyi talks say then they expect Super Eagles players for Nigeria of inside the country this weekend, while the coach go show face on Saturday. The media officer talks say Gennaro Rohr go come from Egypt, where he go support the national under-23 team, as in they prepare for the African under-23 Nations Cup. My people, now the size of our package be that. But before we go, make we tell you now waiting from our top Tori. Federal government don't declare Monday, November 11, as public holiday. Senate don't demand the building of fire stations for big market across Nigeria. DSS men with an attached to Vice President Yemi Osinbajo office don't allegedly panel beat photojournalists where they work with Vanguard newspaper. And last, court don't shift the case where involved Abdulrasheed Maina will be before Chiamo Pension Reform Tax Team till November 21. My people, now the Tori be that as it take happen for Wazobia Max TV. Thank you, sir, you join us on top this one. My name, Nna Douglas.